Liam, Liam, Liam.
I'm here.
I've been calling your name for 5 minutes. You know the answer to question three?
Yeah, of course. You know what? I think that I'm having connection issues, and so I may just be kicked out at any moment, you know?
What time is it? Oh my God, I'm gonna be late for the talent show.
Hello and welcome to the first and hopefully last virtual Counts Rock North's North's Got Talent talent show. My name is Liam Katz and I'm your host for tonight. When they first told me that I was hosting the talent show, I felt honored because I thought they chose me because I was the most talented and funny person for the job. But it turns out I was the only one that applied. I'm actually really qualified to host. I've hosted at many events and I'm actually a host at a restaurant. It's real fancy. It's called Applebee's. Working at Applebee's is a lot different than my first job, which was mowing lawns. The interview for mowing lawns was short and simple. Have you heard of grass? Yes. When I went to Applebee's, the interview was long and complex. They asked me hard questions like, tell me about yourself, or what do you like to do in your free time? I got nervous and started naming things that I don't actually do, like, well, I don't play video games, I've never kayaked, and I haven't had my first kiss yet. I've learned a lot of life lessons from both jobs. From Applebee's, I learned to always do your best to make the customer happy. And from mowing lawns, I learned to always clean up after a big job, which is why I've started wiping and flushing. I don't know why I'm telling you all this. I know you don't care. You're just here to watch your friend perform. So let's get right into it. Our first performance, we have Faya Malik.
A broken heart is all that's left. I'm still fixing all the cracks. Lost a couple of pieces when I carried it home. I'm afraid of all I am. My mind feels like a foreign land. Silence ring inside my head. Still I carry on. I've spent all of the love I saved. We were always a losing game. Small town boy in a big arcade. I got addicted to a losing game. From my heart, my rose colored land is gone. Still, I carry on. Oh, need your games, game over. Get me off this roller coaster.
Awesome job, Faya. Now, before we get to the next act, I'd like to take a moment to talk about me again. Even if I wasn't hosting tonight, I would still be telling jokes, and that's because I would be doing stand-up comedy. I enjoy making people laugh and telling jokes. Telling a lot of jokes gets you out of a lot of situations. For example, I recently told a girl that I had a crush on her, and she told me she didn't feel the same way. So me, being the jokester I am, I was able to just laugh it off and say, ha-ha, I don't like you that way either. And I think she's convinced, but I'm not sure because she hasn't talked to me since then. Which sucks because, you know, I've been trying to hang out with her and see if she wants to come over to my house or go see a movie, but she said she's busy, which I know she's not busy because I can see her through her bedroom window. But let's get to the next act. The next act is the Inlanders. Enjoy.
They say we're young and we don't know. Won't find out until we grow. Well, I don't know if all that's true, 'cause you got me and baby, I got you. Babe, I got you, babe. I got you, babe. They say our love won't pay the rent before it's earned, our money's all been spent. And I guess that's so we don't have a plot, but at least I'm sure of all the things we got. Babe, I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got flowers in the spring. I got you to wear my ring. And when I'm sad, you're a clown. And if I get scared, you're always around. Don't let them say your hair's too long, 'cause I don't care, with you I can't go wrong. Then put your little hand in mine. There ain't no hill, mountain we can't climb. Babe, I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got you to hold my hand.
I got you to understand.
I got you to walk with me.
I got you to talk with me.
I got you to kiss goodnight.
I got you to hold me tight.
I got you, I won't let go.
I got you to love me so.
I got you, babe.
I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got you, babe.
I got.
Awesome job, guys. Now, this hosting thing is getting really hard because the school has a lot of restrictions on what I can and can't say. I'm not the type to make inappropriate jokes or anything, but these restrictions can be a real pain in the... Well, I can't say because of the restrictions. But I've always kept my jokes family-friendly, as long as the family is all above the age of 18. What can I say? I like my jokes like I like my underwear. Brief and dirty. Next act, we have Gianna Moreni. Enjoy.
Nothing special, in fact, I'm a bit of a bore. When I tell a joke, you've probably heard it before. But I have a talent, a wonderful thing, 'cause everyone listens when I start to sing. I'm so grateful and proud. All I want is to sing it out loud. So I say thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me. Mother says I was a dancer before I could walk. She says I began to sing long before I could talk. But I often wonder, how did it all start? Who found out that nothing could capture a heart like a melody can? Well, whoever it was, I'm a fan. So I say thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me.
Great job, Gianna. Now, before the next act, I would like to make it clear that I am single and looking. And the reason I am single is because women are extremely hard to talk to. Like, they make it seem like they're complimenting you when it's not really a compliment. I was talking to a girl, and she said, oh, you're kind of cute. Kinda. Like, what if it was flipped the other way around? I told a girl, oh, you're kind of pretty. Oh, thank you. No, you're not pretty. You're kind of pretty. You're pretty close to being pretty. My grandmom is surprised that I don't have a girlfriend. She thinks I'm the most handsome boy in the world, but she also says that to all my cousins. My mom thinks I have a secret girlfriend. I don't know why, but she thinks I'm still in middle school. She's so convinced that I have a secret girlfriend that she actually bought me diamond earrings to give to my non-existent girlfriend for Christmas. Next up, we have Kelly Lau. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Great job. Now, it seems like we've got a lot of snow this year, and snow used to be a good thing. We used to get off for snow, but now that we can have school on snow days, it seems like Mother Nature's just shoving it in our face. I got tired of snow really quickly. I got tired of talking about snow. I got tired of shoveling snow. But most importantly, I got tired of pretending to want the money that the old ladies were giving me for helping shoveling their driveways. Next up, we got Old Blue Eyes Connor Ross. Take it away. The show is going great, and now I know what you're all wondering. Liam, what did you do during quarantine? Well, what I did during quarantine was a lot different than I'm sure what you did during quarantine. I actually got stuck inside the school on March 12th. and this is how it happened.
Like I said, it was March 12th, 2020, one of the most calm yet chaotic days in history. And I had fallen asleep in English class, and no one decided to wake me up. When I did wake up, I found that I was the only person left in the school. I wandered the hallways looking for some form of life, a student, a teacher, a janitor, a cockroach. No one. Nothing. I was completely alone. I wandered for hours looking for someone. I didn't know what to do. And then eventually, I thought, maybe it's a good idea if I just left. So I did. But when I got to the door, I was locked in. I didn't know what to do. I started to panic. That's when I realized that this will be my home for the next 7 months. I was completely isolated from the rest of the world. Of course, I had fun with this. It's not every day you get stuck in the school for 7 months. I know what you're all thinking. Liam, how did you survive? Well, I had to have squared pizza and cartoned milk for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Once in a while, with the money that I had in my pocket, I would get something out of the vending machine, but only on special occasions. I also had to keep myself clean. I would go to the bathroom in the bathroom as usual, but I would also wash my face. Believe it or not, the pink soap in the bathroom is a great moisturizer. For showers, I use the showers in the science classrooms. They have great water pressure. After months of being in the school, my clothes got pretty dirty and worn, so I went into the Lost and Found to get some new clothes. And I think I found my new style. Not long after that, I started to go crazy. I would see myself in the mirror and I would get in arguments with my reflection and I'd call myself things like ugly and stupid. I started watching shows in the auditorium that weren't actually there. I even put on some shows for some imaginary audiences.
Thank you, Council Rock!
Yeah!
I thought I was going to be stuck in there forever. But then one day, I woke up in my own bed. Turns out, it was all a dream. And no, that is not just because I couldn't think of a better ending.
Next up, we have the Prince of Pop.
I'm gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right. As I turn up the collarbone, my favorite winter coat, this wind is blowing my mind. I see the kids in the street with not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them need? A summer's disregard, a broken bottle top, and a one-man soul. They follow each other on the wind, you know, 'cause they got nowhere to go. That's why no one yet to know.
Starting with me, I'm starting with
Great job, Connor. Now, like I said before, I work at Applebee's. So if you're ever hungry or you want to stop in and say hi, make sure you leave your house an hour before you want to get there because of the line at Chick-fil-A. Chick-fil-A is always so busy. It's so busy that you would think that they're handing out the vaccine to COVID. Don't you think it's strange that whenever Chick-fil-A is busy, that the geese around Newtown lessens? Next up, we have Danny Prue. Go get him, Danny.
I still find your head in my bed, in my clothes, in my mouth and in my nose. Oh, who knows if you'll still be there when it's all said and done, or if I'll just find this.
Now, I have to admit, this school year was a lot different than others. The whole first week was basically icebreakers. I don't think teachers knew that we've known each other for almost 12 years. One very common icebreaker was, what did you do during over the summer? What did I do? I survived. Next up, we have Cameron Fleury. Take it away.
It's not simple to say. Most days I don't recognize me, that these shoes and this apron, the place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be, although it's true, I was never attention sweet center. I still remember that girl. she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken and won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine. It's not what I asked for. Sometimes life just slips in through the back door and carves out a person and makes you believe it's all true. And now I've got you. You're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, and no, I would give it all back for a chance to start over and rewrite an ending or two for that girl that I knew, who was reckless just enough, who gets hurt, but who learns how to stuff it up when she's bruised and confused by a man who gets love. And then she'll get stuck and be scared of the life that's inside her, going sugary day till it finally reminds her to fight just a little to bring back. She is lonely most of the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be.
Great job. Now this whole pre-recorded thing is weird because there's no audience to laugh at my jokes, even though I'm pretty sure if there was an audience, no one would laugh at my jokes. In case you didn't know, this is all pre-recorded, so if I do make a mistake... What was I supposed to say? Okay, we'll just cut it out. Okay, cool. Cool. Next up, we have Ryan Gregory. Enjoy. I'm going to go to the next one. Next up, we have, well, he's back again, Mr. Inlander. And I'm pretty sure he retired, so I don't know why he has two acts in the show, but here you go.
How many roads must a man walk down before call him a man? How many seas must the white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? Yes, and how many times must the cannonballs fly before they're forever banned? answer, my friend, is blowing in wind. The answer is blowing in wind. Listen now, many years can a mountain exist? For it is washed to the sea. Yes, and now many years can some people exist, for they're allowed to be free. Yes, and now many times can a man turn his head, pretend that he just doesn't see. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Yes, and how many times must man look up before he can see the sky? Yes, and how many ears must one man have before he can hear people cry? Yes, and how many deaths will it take till he knows too many people have died? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
Another great performance. Now, I'd just like to say the school wants me to remind you that if you are watching this instead of doing your homework, please go do your homework and watch this later. I do my homework, and that is why I am a straight A student. I have all A's, except I do have one B in English. And I have a C in math, and a D in science, and an F in social studies. But other than that, I'm a straight A student. Next up, we have Alex Demetz. You go, Alex.
You say the price of my love's not a price that you're willing to pay. You cry in your tea, which you hurl in the sea when you see me go by. Why so sad? Remember we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. Remember, despite our estrangement, I'm your man. You'll be back soon, you'll see. You'll remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You'll remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all. And when push comes to shove, I will send a fully armed battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. You say our love is draining and you can't go on. When I am gone. And no, don't change the subject, 'cause you're my favorite subject, my sweet submissive subject. You're my loyal royal subject forever and ever and ever. like before. I will fight the fight and win the war for your love, for your praise. And I'll love you till my dying days. When you're gone, I'll go mad. So don't throw away the sting we had. 'Cause when push comes to shove, I will kill your friends and family to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. Everybody.
All right, I'm sad to say that was the last performance, so we will be parting ways, but I would like to thank Salus Health for helping us out and funding this talent show. I hope you enjoyed the show, I hope you enjoyed all the acts, and I hope you enjoyed watching me talk to myself for 2 hours. Have a good night and drive safe.